Hello, this is Athena Lemon from the Wolbachia Project, and today we're talking about Lab 1, Arthropod Collection and Identification. Before you head out in the field, you can use this opportunity to practice designing and conducting an experiment by collecting your arthropods. For example, what type of arthropod do you expect to collect if you set up a trap with yeast and sugar and water versus setting up a trap with sausage? This type of data and experiment is really useful to students and scientists in your area, and you can share your results with apps like iNaturalist. Uploading your data there could help your school or group create a local map of all of the arthropods in your area and how best to collect them. But before you go out in the field, I always like to be really prepared. Let me show you what I take into the field. My best tip is when I'm out in the field, the tool I use most often is actually my phone. And that's because I take pictures of everything. I take pictures of the environment, I take pictures of the arthropod in its natural environment, and I might take a video to remind myself where I found it, what the weather was like that day, and what the arthropod was doing, how it was moving. These become really handy later on when you try to identify your arthropod. When I go out to collect arthropods, whether I have collected them in a trap or not, I always take a couple things. First, some 1.5 mL tubes. I always take these with me, whether they're dry, or fill them with 70% ethanol before I go out, or isopropanol, which is rubbing alcohol. That way, when I take my forceps out in the field and I find something really small, I can just pick it up and put it directly into my tube. I make sure that I label everything really well. I might put a shorthand label on the top and a more detailed label on the side, but I'll bring out a notebook or something and write down everything that I know about that arthropod in the notebook. If I am going out and don't know what I'm going to collect, I'll also take certain jars with me. You can see there's an arthropod I collected last week. And when I collect my arthropods, if I collect them in a jar like this, I'll trap them, collect them, and then I'll put them in the freezer overnight. And then the next day, I'll open it up, and then I'll take my arthropod. You can see this is a type of beetle that I have here. And I'll put it into my tube and add ethanol directly to the tube. Storing your arthropod in alcohol in the freezer is the best way to store your arthropod. Once you have your arthropod in a labeled tube, you can leave it in your freezer for up to a few months before extracting the DNA. I really can't stress enough how important it is to take really good notes and really good pictures. Later, when you're identifying, you'll thank yourself for taking so many pictures. In addition to the pictures I take in the field, I also take some pictures in lab. I'll take my arthropod either out of the alcohol or before I put it in alcohol, and I'll take some pictures against a white background. I just use a paper towel. I take them with my phone and I get really detailed pictures. If you have a macro lens or even a cheap little microscope, you can get some really cool pictures that way. And that way, that will help you identify your arthropod later on in this lab. Okay, now that we've collected our arthropod, it's time to identify it. You probably have a pretty good idea of what you collected, and you might even know the common name for it, but we're going to use taxonomy to identify our arthropod. You might be familiar with the Linnaean classification system, which uses a hierarchy of groupings. If you're familiar with this system, you're probably familiar with kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Because we're only collecting arthropods in this project, we're only going to look at the phylum Arthropoda. And from there, you only need to classify to order. Let's look at some examples. Let's say that I collected a roly-poly or a pill bug. These are really common in dark, damp places. I know that it's an arthropod belonging to the phylum Arthropoda. With a little bit of research, I know that it belongs to the class Malacostraca. I know that it's an isopod belonging to the order Isopoda. And because I'm confident that it's a pill bug, they're really unique, they're easily identifiable, I know that it belongs to the family, get this, Armadillidiidae. So I would say my pill bug is classified in the family Armadillidiidae. Another good example is a ladybug. We know that it's in the phylum Arthropoda, and I know that it's an insect. Insects are really common, and most of the time when you collect a bug, you're actually collecting an insect. From there, I know that a ladybug's a beetle, so it would be classified in the order Coleoptera. And because ladybugs, again, are so distinct, I know that it's in the family Coccinellidae. To go any further than that, I would need to see the markings on the back of the ladybug and refer back to my pictures. 7 spotted ladybugs are really common, whereas 2 spotted ladybugs are not. Ladybugs can sometimes be classified by the spots on their back. But I'm confident that it's in the family Coccinellidae, so that's what I will classify it as. This sample, or this ladybug, is classified in the family Coccinellidae. Because insects are so common, and at least one of what you'll collect is probably an insect, we have this sheet of common insect orders. So for example, if you collected a beetle, like a ladybug, it would be in the order Coleoptera. If you collected an ant or a wasp, it would be in the order Hymenoptera. And we have common orders in this list right here. If you collected a fly, it would be classified in the order Diptera, because the prefix di means 2, and the suffix tera means wings. Flies only have 2 wings. And that's how you can classify your arthropod to order. Once you've collected and identified your arthropod, you can start filling out an entry on our database. Our database is an online repository to share your data and information with other scientists, students, and Wolbachia researchers across the world. Once you fill out the observations page, you can just publish that as is and always go back to it to edit as you go along this project. Once you're done, I'll see you in Lab 2, DNA extraction.